Okay, so after the death of Alauddin Khilji, Tughlaq dynasty came to the power. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, who founded this Tughlaq dynasty after the 4 years of death of Alauddin Khilji. And at this time of Tughlaq dynasty, Dak Choti, means the postal services, also came in. And at that time, letters were covered and carried by the horse. And the postmen were referred to as Halkaru. Okay, this mom after Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, Muhammad Tughlaq became the Sultan. Okay, and the many decisions that he took were criticized, means people didn't believe in his decision, and his decisions were usually criticized. And the two main plans were to the transfer of capital from Delhi to Tughlakabad and introducing the use of copper currencies. Means what he did, the capital that was in Delhi was transferred to Tughlakabad, and he also started the copper currency. These were the two decisions that was criticized by people. And Muhammad Tughlaq means what would happen, an African traveler from Bennett belonged to the Hafsi tribe visited India. And the Sultan's administration, he used to criticize the Sultan's administration, and he has written that Muhammad Shah's rule was an amalgamation of both good and bad administrative policies. Means he has said in his one of his books that this ruler's, Muhammad Shah's rule was amalgamation of both good and bad. Means it has some good effects and some bad sides also. Means it's a mixture of both good and bad policies. Okay, so that is about Tughlaq dynasty. Now we will see about the Hindu kingdom of Vijayanagar. So this sultans, actually what they tried to expand their kingdom, and in that expansion they have also they were also attracted towards South India, and they wanted to their authority, their power in South India also. And Alauddin Khilji was the first ruler who tried to attack South India, but and he also to carry away numerous wealth from Delhi. Means उन्होंने बहुत loot है, means they have gained many thing from Delhi, wealth from Delhi. And Malik Kafur destroyed the kingdom of Varangal, and the condition of South India worsened during the time of Muhammad Tughlaq, because he kept on doing what. So they wanted to gain power over South India. They attacked South India several times. So what happened? The situation worsened day by day. And the Hindu Empire of Vijayanagar and Bahamani State were also established in South India.
Water can be reached to different parts of his kingdom.
also created several temples and forts in the kingdom that were grand and were known for their architecture style. And his glorious state was destroyed at the Battle of Kalakota. Okay, turn image, new topic, Bahmani Sultanate.
Okay, Bahmani Sultanate. So this Amis has a problem with the different Sultanate coming and going. So they started to rebel, means they were not following the rules. So Hasan, one of the efficient Amiris, became the Sultanate and he founded what? The Bahmani Sultanate. And Muhammad Gawan was a capable minister. Among this Bahmani Sultanate, who was a capable one than Muhammad Gawan, and his administration was very efficient and was well known during Bahmani Sultanate. He won many territories and also extended the boundaries of Bahmani Kingdom. Means he has also fought like a brave person and has also won many territories and also extended the boundaries. The power of Bahmani Sultanate weakened after his death. Once this Muhammad Gawan died, what happened? His Sultanate became weak. And then after the frequent conflicts between the Vijayanagar and Bahmani Kingdom, the downfall of Bahmani Sultanate, many provinces became independent. And among this, five provinces of Bijapur, Ahmednagar, Golconda, Berar and Bidra became established independent kingdom. So what happened? There was a conflict between Vijayanagar and Bahmani Kingdom, and as this Bahmani Kingdom was already weakened by the death of Muhammad Gawan, the downfall of Bahmani Sultanate happened and many parts became independent sultanates. Okay, the end of Delhi Sultanate. So Firoz Shah Tughlaq ascended the throne, after whom we have seen Muhammad Tughlaq. His administration was amalgamation of good and bad. So once Muhammad Tughlaq died, who came to power? Firoz Shah Tughlaq. And from that time onwards, the Delhi Sultanate became too weakened, means their power was vanishing. The reign of Tughlaq dynasty also witnessed the invasion and plunder of Delhi by Timur. So what happened? Many invaders came in. They wanted the power of Delhi. The governor of Lahore, Hijra Khan, took advantage of all the chaos, means all ye jo problems chal rahi thi, jo power invasions, जो फाइट हो रही थी, इसका फ़ायदा किसने उठाया? लाहौर के खिराजा खान ने. एंड ही एस्टैब्लिश द सैयद डायनेस्टी इन दिल्ली. देन द अथॉरिटी ऑफ द सुल्तान्स वर लिमिटेड टू द रीजन अराउंड दिल्ली. एंड द कंप्लीट पावर वॉज टेकन बाय लाहौर खिजरा खान. एंड द अफगान लीडर सरदार भलो एस्टैब्लिश द रूल ऑफ लोडी डायनेस्टी इन Delhi. His son Sikandar Lodi ascended the throne after Afghan leader Sardar. This Sikandar Lodi had a good qualities of all the good qualities what a good leader needed, a good ruler needed. But what he lacked in religious tolerance. He could not tolerate religious things. And once he died, his Ibrahim Lodi defeated his elder brother and became the ruler of Delhi. But this Amiris were not happy because of his arrogant attitude, and he started to rebel, means they started to go against the kingdom's rule. And then Babur, the emperor of Kabul, invaded Delhi at that same time. Invaded means एकदम घुसपैठ करना बोलते हैं ना वैसे. The emperor of Kabul invaded Delhi at that time and he defeated whom? Who was the ruler that time? Ibrahim Lodi. And the battle of Panipat was fought and founded the Mughal Empire, which lasted for approximate 200 years. So if someone asks you who is the founder of Mughal Empire in Delhi, then it is Babur, the emperor of Kabul, who invaded Delhi and fought the Battle of Panipat and founded the Mughal Empire, which lasted for a long 200 years. So by this topic we came to an end of this chapter. I hope the terms and the words that came in this chapter you are well aware about. If there is any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.